Hello students, in the previous lecture we have calculated the radius of curvature at an arbitrary point on the curve. And we know that the radius of curvature varies from point to point on the curve. So now in this lecture we'll discuss the radius of curvature at the origin. At the origin, if the origin passes through the curve or origin does not pass. So we have three methods to find the radius of curvature at the origin. First is radius of curvature at the origin of the curve y is equal to fx can be obtained by putting x equal to 0 and y is equal to 0 in the value of the radius of curvature obtained by the method discussed earlier in the previous lecture. Now, the second method is to find the radius of curvature at the origin, we have the method of extension. When the curve given by y is equal to fx passes through the origin, then we'll expand the fx in the neighborhood of x equal to 0 or in the we'll apply Maclaurin's theorem from 0 to x. The distance from 0 to x or Maclaurin's theorem at 0 at the origin. For the extension of y is equal to fx. So its extension will be y is equal to fx f 0 plus x into f dash at 0 plus x cube total f dash 0 and so on. Okay. Since the curve passes through the origin, so therefore f at 0 will be 0. So put f 0 here in this equation, in the equation second. So we will obtain y is equal to fx is equal to x into f dash at 0 plus plus x squared root of total f double dash at 0 and so on. So we know that derivative at 0, let us suppose that derivative of f at 0 is equal to p and second derivative of f at 0 is equal to q. Where f p is equal to first derivative of y square x at 0, 0 q is equal to second derivative of f at 0 or second derivative of y square at 0. So after comparison, comparing from this, go to the value of p and q and substitute the value of p and q. So this curvature at origin will be equal to 1 plus p square which will throw to open q. Now Newton's method. The curve y is equal to fx passes through the origin and x axis acts as the tangent to the curve at the origin. Then a curve passes through origin, then at x is 0, y at 0 is equal to 0, and if the x is tangent, therefore differential y is to x, that p is equal to 0. And the q is equal to second derivative of y is to x at 0. Then in the Maclaurin's extension y of equal fx in the interval 0 to x, we have y is equal to f at 0 plus f dash at 0 x plus f second dash 0 x square root. Put f at 0, the origin passes through the origin and tangent x is tangent, this will be equal to 0. So y is equal to q into x to the 2 and so on. Now divide both sides by x square by 2 by x square. Multiply both sides by 2 x square. So we got 2 y upon x square is equal to q plus terms of x. So if we take the limit as x is to infinity, we'll get the value of this term 0. So this will get the value of q. The limit on x approaches to 0, x to 0 precise. So limit x is 0 of y upon x square will be p. So substitute will p, rho at 0 will be equal to 1 plus p will be 0, this one upon q is equal to limit x is to 0 of x square upon. So rho can be written by if x axis is the tangent to the origin, then limit x is to 0 of x square upon y will act in the rho at 0. Now if y axis is tangent to the curve at origin, then similarly because of this, this will limit rho will given by limit x is to 0 of y square by 2x. If neither x axis nor x is tangent to the curve at origin, then we'll put y is equal to px plus qx square by 2 and so on in the equation of the given curve and find the value of p and q from here. Now, find p and q, this equation is p and q, so should the value, we'll get the need to get the radius of curvature at origin. So we'll solve the problem this one time. Find the radius of curvature at the origin to the curve, this curve. Now this curve, fx equal to 0. Given curve is this, fx is 0. If you put x equal to 0, if x equal to 0 is 0, equation is 0. This origin lies on the f0 from 0, this 0 origin lies on the curve first. Then and find the equation of tangent at 0, 0. Put the coefficient of lowest degree terms in the equation first, 0, which will be equal to these terms. Those two terms, these are y square minus 3xy plus x square is equal to 0. Factorize them. After separation, we got the equations. So, either this or this is a tangent. So, neither x axis nor y axis is a tangent to the curve at origin. So, we have to put method discussed earlier. Put y equal to px plus q, x equal to 2, and so on in the equation first and simplify that. So, this the fxy becomes 0. Now, we want to find the p and q. So, this is equation. This will be equation. So, each degree term must be 0. So, we require two equations to find the p and q. So, write the sending power of x, sending power of x, and then put the lowest degree terms. Find two equations, find the p and q. Find two equations. So, this polynomial is equal to 0. Polynomial in p q is 0. Polynomial x cube, polynomial x will be 0 if the coefficient of this will be coefficient of x square, coefficient x cube, so 4 will be 0. So we'll copy coefficient x square is equal to 0 and q is equal to 0. Two equations and I have substitute to find out p and q. From these two equations, so we'll find that this quadratic for p and q, p q. And substitute the value of p in the second equation, which can get p is equal to 1, p is equal to minus 1, p is equal to 1, sorry. P is equal to 1, q is equal to minus 2. And p is equal to 2, q is equal to minus 2. Now at p, q we can find, at p is equal to 1, q is to minus 2, we can find the this curvature at 0, 0, and set this curvature. And so, sin is 2. Now if p is equal to 2, q is equal to 2, then radius curvature will be this. So p and q, so p. After this year, we will be able to learn Q. Okay? Yes. Now, find the radius curvature of the curve, this curve, 4, 3x square plus 4x minus 12 to 0. Equation of the curve passes origin, 0, 0, x is 0, y 0, this will be 0, all lies on the ground. Now, to find the equation of tangent to the origin, put the coefficient of y is equal to 0. Y is equal to 0 means x axis is like the tangent to the curve. So, therefore, the value, the radius coefficient at origin will be limit x equals to 0 of x upon y. And so, dividing both sides by convert this into x square by y. Dividing both equation by 2y. 2y convert this. So, this will be as if you take the limit x equals to 0, this will become 2p. Now, taking limit here x equals to 0, so this will become rho and this will rho. And this will become 6 and limit. Now take a limit of this. Now we get the linear equation p and p comes out to be sorry, linear equation rho and rho comes out to be p. Another method, Newton method. Apply Newton method to find the radius curvature at the origin of the cycloid. This is cycloid in this parametric form, theta parameter. These two equations. Now differential is theta, find differential x is theta, y is theta, and the and now. Therefore, the y is x. So, to substitute the value, tan theta, add theta equal to 0, dy dx is equal to tan theta, dy dx is equal to tan theta 0, so p is equal to, p and y is equal to 0. Y equal to 0, add theta equal to 0. Therefore, therefore this curve, the cycloid passes through the origin and x axis tangent to the curve. Therefore, the equation of the cycloid passes through the origin and x axis is tangent, therefore rho will be equal to limit x is 0 of x over 2y. Substitute value of x square and 2y. Now take the limit of this x to 2y. This is equal to now this is equal to define the limit, this is 0, 0 form. Multiply again the rule, measure this. This again becomes 0, 0. Again applying the physical rule. to find the value of rho equal to 4. Find the radius of the curvature at the origin to the curve, this in parametric form t is equal to the equation of the curve in parametric form are x is equal to this, 1 minus t square, y equal to t minus t square. Now we will eliminate t from equation first and second and convert the equation of the term fx. Alright, we find it in this method or by this method. So now y is equal to t common minus tx. So t is equal to y upon x. T is equal to y upon x. From first in first and second, y upon x. From this equation in the first or in second, t is equal to first or second, we got the equation. This is equal to so fx y equal to 0. Now to 0, the partial origin. Parametric convention can be converted into this form. So this is equal to orbital particular dimension. So f 0 0 0. Okay. Now our aim is to show that x is lying in the curve. Origin of the point is lying in the curve. This shows it as fx 0 0 0. To find the equation of tangents, put the lowest degree term is equal to. Lowest term is equal to x plus y is 0. So x is equal to x plus y, x minus 1. So two tangents are x is equal to minus y, x is equal to y. Hence, tangents at origin are neither x nor x. So if tangents are neither x nor x, then we have to put y is equal to px plus q x equal to and so on in the equation, given equation, and simplify that. Now again, we have to find the value of p and q. P and Q, so put the lowest degree term, write in the ascending power of x and put the coefficient of lowest degree because this is zero polynomial. So coefficient of x must be zero, coefficient of x must be zero, coefficient of x must be 4 must be and so on. So we need two equations to find P and Q. Put the lowest degree term is equal to zero, this term zero and next term zero and so on. So we need two equations from this first equation because P is equal to 1 minus 1 and put the value P in the second equation, the value is Q. And P is equal to 1, Q is equal to minus 1, P is equal to minus 1, Q is equal to 1. Now we can find the radius curvature at p is equal to 1, q minus 1. So radius curvature and p is equal to minus 1, q is equal to 1.